नमस्कार फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज एनजे, ये होस्ट ऑन दिस चैनल। सो गाइज, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल हैव अवर डिस्कशन ऑन द अपकमिंग ट्रांसिट ऑफ द प्लैनेट मर्करी, व्हिच ऑन सितंबर 23rd इज गोइंग टू बी एंटरिंग द साइन ऑफ वर्गो, एंड फ्रॉम सितंबर 23rd टिल अक्टूबर 9th इट्स गोइंग टू बी एग्जॉल्टेड इन इट्स ओन टेरिटोरी। सो गाइज, द सेंसिटिव पार्ट अबाउट दिस ट्रांसिट ऑफ मर्करी इज दैट डेफिनेटली फ्रॉम इट्स साइन प्लेसमेंट इट इज अ गुड डिग्निफाइड स्टेट फॉर द प्लैनेट ऑफ द डिस्क्रिमिनेटरी इंटेलिजेंस, फॉर द प्लैनेट ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन और द बिजनेस एक्यूमेन। बट गाइज, द ओनली कंसर्न इज दैट वंस इट इज गोइंग टू गेट in the Virgo sign, it is going to get conjunct with the Ketu, and it is going to be a part of the we call this the solar eclipse as well, which is scheduled to take place on October 2nd. So guys, definitely when we talk about individually Mercury, it might not be responsible for all the magical, unexplainable or prodigious things which our mind can function or can perform. But whenever Mercury comes in the contact of this could be Rahu, this could be Ketu, somehow it becomes very potent, it becomes exceptionally strong. Whenever we use the word unusually strong, intelligent, exceptionally talented or gifted, over there the role of notes always comes into picture. Like the way guys, I just when I woke up today, I woke up to this news that India in some chess category won some prize and all, and it happened for the very first time. So these kind of people who win these kind of Olympiads, these kind of tournaments and all, and whose mind is exceptionally gifted, you will definitely find these people to be under the influence of Mercury, somehow making a combination with Ketu. Now guys, over here, see, when we talk about Mercury and Rahu, it has got a dual side to it. As much as it can make you very adept in anything to do with the technology, foreign trade or a new age innovative sciences and all, but when we talk about Mercury and Ketu, so in extreme cases it can actually make someone very dumb as well, make you completely bereft of your to make good decision at the right time. It can completely negate or slow down those qualities, or in extreme cases it can also bless you with some sort of talents from the past life as well. You might demonstrate those talents for which there is no scientific rational explanation. But yes guys, with this combination taking place in the Virgo, and along with that its conjunction with Sun, aspect of the planet Mars from the Gemini, aspect of the planet Jupiter from the sign Taurus, definitely is giving a lot of emphasis in the zodiac sign of Virgo. And guys, we all know this thing that Mercury is a very impressionable planet. The kind of influence you expose it to, it start behaving accordingly. And during this time, Mercury is in its own territory. It is well supported by planets, well aspected by planets. So definitely, pertaining to the domain of the Virgo, some good results can be expected. So okay guys, now after this, when we talk about the general remedies for the Mercury, we generally say this thing that the recitation of the Vishnu Sahasranam is the best thing which you can consider doing. Donating some money, if you are living in India, to the eunuchs, specifically on Wednesday, should be considered. Feeding cows, spinach and all should be considered. So these all are the things. You have to increase that energy. So even consuming green lentils on Wednesday should be considered in order to give more and more strength and power to this Mercury. But still guys, I would say because of the conjunction with Ketu and all, so starting your day with the Atharv Ganeshish Stotra should be considered. Offering Modak, Laddus at the Lord Ganesha's temple should be considered. And somehow Wednesday is strongly connected with Lord Ganesha, so you can consider visiting Lord Ganesha's temple and seeking Bappa's, Ganpati's blessing on a Wednesday as well. So okay guys, now we will shift our discussion customized to all the rising signs. So guys, when we talk about the Aries natives, so definitely guys, in your case, Mercury is not a very strong planet for you, and your sixth house is getting exceptionally strong with the involvement of the nodes as well. So the one thing which I want to highlight over here is that, let's say for example, if you are working in the domain of the sixth house, you are a lawyer, you work in the loan department, you are a health fitness expert and all, those people can get benefited. But apart from that, all the troubles obstacles which are connected with the sixth house. Problems on the account of enemies and the lawsuit, health related issues. So do not be very sensitive pertaining to any of the threatful related situation of the sixth house. If you feel that the weather is changing, you might get sick or get cold and all, so wear proper clothes. If you know that confronting this junior subordinate is going to be a issue, so avoid the confrontation. If you know that if during this time I will make any amendments in my daily health regime, it is going to disrupt my life, so avoid taking those decisions when you know that your sixth house is in such a potent state. Now guys, when we talk about the Taurus natives, so definitely guys, in your case, Mercury has got a rulership over your second house and the fifth house, and it is going to be getting potent and powerful over there. So definitely guys, even your ascendant lord in the transit is in a good state, transiting in its own sign. Along with that guys, trine houses are generally considered as very good. So definitely doing mantra chanting should be considered. Any of the artistic creative pursuit during this time can actually create some very magical results for sure. Even guys, for all those students who have to write any important exam or any of the concerns of academics and all, so looks like you are headed in the right direction. The charm and the personal magnetism is going to be exceptionally strong during this time, and this is a strong possibility for people who are spiritually oriented that they can demonstrate some unusual exceptional talents as well. Now guys, when we talk about the Gemini natives, definitely guys, in your case, Mercury is your ascendant lord, and now it is going to be transiting, getting exalted in your fourth house. So yes guys, although in the original Kalpurush Kundli, this is not a very good placement for Mercury, because over here Mercury goes through a lot of the back and forth of the logics and the emotions. But guys, if your business concerns are somehow connected with the fourth house related matters, so I would say that during this time there could be some, like, had there been some property related deal which is not getting clear, it is getting struck at the last minute, you might get some clarity over there. Lot many people, specifically around the time of the solar eclipse, might find themselves little bit anxious. So anxiety is something you might have to deal with. Do not overthink pertaining to the matters of any domestic issue which you had in the past, or digging issues of the past with your family members. So it's not a very good energy for pondering over the wounds and issues of your family related matters. So these are the certain things which I want to say to the Gemini natives. But yes guys, it is your ascendant lord and it is exalted. It will definitely have some good things in store for you. Now guys, when we talk about the Cancer natives, definitely guys, in your case, Mercury is not a very favorable planet for you. Now it is going to be getting exalted in your third house. So guys, definitely during this time we say this thing that third house has got a lot of the headstrongness, willfulness attached to it, and over here, because it's the planet of your mental rationality and intelligence, so lot many Cancer Lagna natives during this time are going to be very forceful. Whatever thought or whim or plan or strategy comes to their mind, they will put everything at their disposal to put it in the execution. Now guys, this attitude approach might work in your professional endeavors, but might not get along very well with people around you. This could be you might suddenly offend your younger sibling, or might offend your colleagues because of your headstrong approach or attitude, or not paying too much attention to the details, or getting obsessed with the details. We know the influence of the Ketu over there. So this is all what I can say, that yes, as much as it is it could be good for new initiative, but when we talk about, or this could be good for your social media projection, marketing related concerns and all, but when it comes down to maintaining that harmony with people around you in your personal relationship, it can cause a disruption over there, so be careful. Now guys, when we talk about the Leo natives, so definitely guys, in your case, as you can see that Mercury is like your treasurer, and it is getting exalted in your second house. So definitely guys, when we talk about the matters of your speech, of your finances, of your family, there's definitely a very upward surge in the energy which will work in your favor. So let's say for example, from the past couple of weeks, there has been some payment, some deal which got struck somewhere, you will definitely find the clarity over there. Mercury has been like, before it was transiting in the 12th house, when it was over your ascendant, it was receiving they expect from the planet Saturn as well. Now it is in a good state, and all the planets, like whether Jupiter transiting Mars, conjunct with Sun, they all are supporting towards it. So my recommendation is that yes, in the matters of your second house, some clarity is something where you are headed. And the only thing is that, guys, I will not say that this conjunction with Ketu is making you vulnerable, but yes, when it comes down to some sort of wounds of the past, that might trouble around the time of the solar eclipse, because it is the solar eclipse, your ascendant is ruled by the Sun. So around the time of the eclipse, do not go or ponder over the negative feeling or past wounds with your immediate family, because it is going to trouble you more. But when it comes down to the matters of the financial structure and financial health of yours, over there there is should be some breakthrough and some clarity. Now guys, when we talk about the Virgo natives, definitely guys, it is your ascendant lord, and this whole alignment is taking place right over there in your first house. So guys, one thing is for sure that you have to give attention to your health. As much as it might be good for your like I would say that suddenly coming into limelight, or those kind of, you know, prophecy omens and those sort of intuitive kind of hunches and feelings and all, it might be good for all that kind of concerns. But when we talk about that your health and all, especially around the time of the solar eclipse, Sun in your case has got a rulership over your 12th house as well. So health is something regarding which you have to be very careful. Second thing is that definitely guys, your mind will work in a very astute, in a very precise way during this time, because Ketu has been connected with the flag, hoisted flag of accomplishment, achievement, that you have now a strong claim over that territory. And because Mercury is not only your ascendant lord, it is your 10th lord as well. So whatever is going to happen during this time, and this could be a case that a success or a reward or a recognition which has been passed long overdue, that might be bestowed upon. And not only it is going to be good for your career, but it will also be good for your public image as well. The only concern is that health needs to be very strongly monitored, and we all know this thing, the domain of the Mercury. This could be skin related concern, nervous system problem, anxiety, depression. So you have to be very careful around these department. Guys, let me have a quick sip of tea. Okay guys, now when we talk about the Libra natives, so definitely guys, in your case, Mercury is a good friend of your ascendant lord Venus, and just because it has got a rulership over your 9th house as well, so it is a favorable planet for you. So yes guys, in the transit, Mercury is going to be transiting in your 12th house. So definitely guys, this is a good time for anything to do with the like we say that intuitive insight, emotional cleansing, letting things go, or like these are the typical alignments for which the sadhu, sannyasi and the sadhak people, all the tantra connected people, they wait for these kind of alignments. We all know this thing that for anyone to do any mantra sadhana, see, if you're not torturing your body in order to please your God, a lot of us, majority of us in today's modern day and age are engaging in any sort of sadhana through the chanting only, through the mantra, through resorting refuge in the mantra only. And this is that typical alignment where people get that feeling of enlightenment, or they experience that fructification in their sadhana, in their bhakti. So yes guys, because you know, Mercury getting conjunct with Ketu, which is the planet of the spirit world, the power behind any spell is the power of Ketu. And 12th house is something where all these energies reside. So yes guys, as much as it is good for your sadhana, bhakti, devotion, and see guys, whatever I'm saying for the spiritually aligned people, it is more or less equally aligned with the creative people as well. Sudden insight, you know, I still remember a lot many artists and creative people say that they always keep a diary or something with them. Like now because it's a time of the cell phones and all, you can just record it, that whatever and whenever any new idea, any new inspiration comes to them, they immediately record it. So this is how you have to behave around during this time, especially the creative profession professionals. And keep your mind as calm as possible, because you are being very well guided by nature during this time, that whatever is meant for you, you will see the pattern getting formed around you. So for all the magical, esoteric, unusuality, phenomena, circumstances, it is a good time. But along with that, guys, when it comes down to specifically the travels, there might be some inconveniences over there. Along with that, I would say that lot many people, if your moon is weak in your natal chart, lot many people will feel anxiety, or they might be very very highly strung as well. And let's say, for example, if you're already going through some yoke of having losses, like let's say, for example, if in your natal chart, your second lord is afflicted in the 12th house and Ketu transiting over it, and it is also activated in the Pratyantar Dasha, Antar Dasha, then this is a typical time when people endure heavy losses, and it happens in a very sudden way. So my recommendation, recitation of Vishnu Sahasranam and offering Modak to Lord Ganesha's temple on the Wednesdays. And like a third person, try to be observant of whatever is happening around you. Like the way, I was teaching meditation to someone, and what I told her that, okay, the first thing is that you have to act like a third person to your thoughts. You have to be in that thoughtlessness state, and do not engage in any thought, just observe them like a third person. So all of that is getting applicable for the Libra natives as well. Okay guys, now when we talk about the Scorpions, so definitely guys, in your case, Mercury is not a very favorable planet for you, and now it is going to be getting exalted and getting conjunct with Ketu in your 11th house. See guys, the irony of the Mars is that, see, because I already started working on the yearly horoscope for next year for all the rising signs, and when I was just observing the pattern getting formed in the next year, being a Mars ruled rising sign by myself, I was very sad to see the state of the Mars. Mars is actually going to be spending like till May and June, it is going to be getting back and forth in the signs where it is not comfortable. So yes, whether you are Aries, whether you are Scorpio, you have to be very careful around the next 5-6 months. Do not try to bring any forceful, sudden, unpredictable change, and be very watchful, mindful of your actions. Refrain from getting a part of something which is very unethical, or kind of, you know, taking extreme chances, or that sort of leap of faith and all. So you have to be very, very careful. And yes guys, in your case, the 8th lord is getting exalted in the 11th house and getting conjunct with Ketu. So there's a strong possibility that some sort of, you know, sudden kind of rift within your social circle, network circle, could happen during this time. The possibility of that is going to be very strong around the time of the solar eclipse. So you have to be a little bit careful around there. Second thing is that definitely guys, a lot many times, because Ketu conjunction with Sun, although in the Leo and the Aries in the 11th, is considered as the yoga of the mass fame. So my recommendation is that yes, in certain cases, in sudden unpredictable way, power or big opportunity can be bestowed upon if that is something which you have earned from the past so long. But yes, my recommendation still is that because your ascendant lord is afflicted, do not believe things on the face value. So take everything with a pinch of salt. And along with that, when we talk about your capacity to foresee any opportunity and all, regarding that front, it's a good combination, because whenever there's a 8th house involvement, and whenever there's an involvement of like Mercury being exalted in the influence of Ketu in the house of income and gains, people tend to remain very psychic and very perceptive enough to foresee any opportunity. So that is all I can say for the Scorpions. Now guys, when we talk about the Sagittarius rising natives, so definitely guys, in your case, as you can see that Mercury is going to be getting exalted in your 10th house, getting conjunct with Ketu over there. So guys, one thing is for sure that we all know this thing that Mercury is very strong. Definitely if you are working as a research analyst, you're working as an auditor. So those people can still get benefited. Or let's say, for example, if you're working in the domain of something to do with the priesthood, connected to the fields of spirituality, mathology, religion and all, those people can still get benefited. But apart from that, guys, a lot of many times it has been seen. See, Mercury is a very good manager. Mercury is a very good multitasker. Now you put the influence of Ketu over there, somehow Ketu slows you down because it wants you to be precise in one thing rather than shuffling and juggling with multiple things. So during this time, bosses could be a little bit critical around you, around your work. You have to be a little bit careful around there, because guys, see, your ascendant lord is already transiting in your sixth house. So somehow you are in the scrutiny of the bosses, and whatever you need to get done, you have to go through first some initial hurdle or setback. This is the kind of pattern which your ascendant lord has created for you right now in the transit. And over and above that, this combination is just telling about that, yes, for certain people they can get benefited if your field is connected with the Mercury and Ketu theme. But for rest of the people, bosses around you are going to be very critical. So pay attention to the detail. That is all what I can say. In certain cases, it can also facilitate sudden rise to position, or certain people might be suddenly get considered for some sort of new opportunity, new role as well. Now guys, when we talk about the Capricorn natives, so definitely guys, in your case, as you can see that Mercury is a very important planet for you. It is the sixth lord as well, and getting exalted in the ninth house. So definitely guys, Mercury getting exalted in the ninth house, getting conjunct with Ketu in the influence of Sun, is definitely a good news. That in itself tells about that, yes, like any of the concerns of like your religious austerities will actually reap some very good results. The same thing, guys, which I mentioned when I was talking about for the Libra natives, that Mercury getting exalted, getting conjunct with Ketu in the 12th house. This is the kind of time which all the practitioners, religious practitioners and the sadhaks, they wait for that sort of golden opportunity, which can only happen in years. Rahu and Ketu are going to be in the same alignment only after 18 years. So I mean to say that, okay, this is the golden time which you are going through. Whatever faith you are connected with, and whomsoever you call and see as your Isht Devta, reading the holy books connected with that God will definitely give you the insight for the way forward. Along with that, guys, travels could be a little bit troublesome. Not a very good energy during this time for filing any immigration or signing any documentation, papers and all. Be very careful that you should not miss out on any important details. There could be some sort of sudden conflict with the father as well, because during this time only, the solar eclipse is going to be taking place in the ninth house. Sun has got a rulership over your eighth house, and in the influence of Ketu in the ninth house, during the time of eclipse, be cautious, be careful, not getting into straight argument with your father. For the teachers or people connected with judiciary, people connected with law, they might stand a chance for some sudden opportunity as well, some sudden breakthrough as well. But guys, my recommendation, in these kind of alignments, we are already going through the Pitra Paksh as well. Stay as much as respectful towards your ancestors, towards the religion you are born in. And along with that, yeah, staying respectful, dutiful towards the family is something which I want to recommend. And the certain professionals which I just mentioned, like people connected with judiciary, people going through higher studies, they can get benefited. Some chance of scholarship, some sort of some recognition might be might happen, materialize for these people. Now guys, when we talk about the Aquarians, so definitely guys, in your case, the solar eclipse is going to be taking place in your 8th house. So yes guys, 8th house energy is a little bit sensitive. We all know this thing that any of the involvement of Ketu with the 8th house could be good for people who are in research, or people who are connected, or they have their interest in the esoteric, mystical side. Like this could be Tantra and all. But for the regular people, it is always recommended that whenever these kind of alignments are taking place, be very cautious and careful when you go close to the nature, animals, and all these kind of places. Like people who have this hobby of going to the very just for the sake of the adventure, going to those places where there's a scarcity of oxygen, deep underground places, diving in the water and all. So just be very careful when you are going close to the nature, when you have this kind of alignment taking place. That's the first thing. Second thing is that definitely, guys, not a very good time to push your luck or try your luck to the extreme in the matters of the stock market, speculation, trading as well. So take calculative risk. That is something which I want to say. Third thing is that those people can still get benefited. Like if you are already working in the loan department or something to do with insurance, you being an insurance agent or some sort of money, some sort of hereditary rights or royalties which have been struck from the past so long. So suddenly that struck money getting released. So this is how things can happen. And along with that, guys, for people who are connected with anything to do with the research, scientific pursuit, you're connected with the fields of occult, tantra, mantra, interest in these things, those people can get benefited. Some sort of landing at some big opportunity in a very sudden, esoteric, mysterious way could get materialized. And along with that, guys, in your case, we all know and we have discussed while we were talking about this solar eclipse that your seventh lord is going to be a part of it as well. So yes, in the matters of the commercial relation, business partnership, even with your partner, you have to be a little bit careful. The concern is that you will be working with the best of your discriminatory intuitive intelligence, but the nature and the circumstances might lead your thought process in the wrong direction. So there's a high possibility and vulnerability of that. But yes, for people who are scientist, astrologer, occultist, it's a golden time. And lastly, guys, for the Pisces rising natives, so definitely, guys, in your case, Mercury is going to be getting exalted in your seventh house, getting conjunct with Ketu. So yes, guys, we know this thing that Mercury in your case has got a rulership over your fourth house as well. So lot many people during this time are going to be a little bit anxious on the account of the development or the experiences which they are already going through in the matters of their matrimonial life. Or I would say that lot many people will be overly stressed around the matters or concerns of the development taking place in their business front or their commercial front. So my recommendation is that during the time of the eclipse or Mercury being conjunct with Ketu, it is not a very good energy to contemplate on the negative side of it or what you are lacking. Rather, make use of this golden time to manifest things or, you know, kind of facilitate the law of attraction for invoking more opportunities in your favor. We all know this thing, guys, that Mercury somehow is connected with the commercial business acumen. And when it comes down to Ketu, Ketu is the Shafa. Ketu is the power behind any mantra, any spell, any austerities which you perform. So yes, my recommendation is that if during this time only you want to install some Vyapar Vriddhi Yantra in your place, or you want to start chanting some mantra, I would say we all know this thing that during the time of the eclipse and all, it's a good time for the chanting, for the spiritual austerities. The Pitra Paksha is not considered as good for buying any kind of happy and favorable auspicious things like buying a car and all of that. But when it comes down to the chanting and the austerities and all, that can be performed. And yes, guys, because Mercury is going to be getting exalted in your seventh house, getting conjunct with Ketu and all, so you will be in a state to think or contemplate or ponder over any situation, like any pros and cons, being able to do a proper SWOT analysis, being able to see the strength, weakness, opportunity, threat in any situation which will arise or erupt in your business front, in your commercial front during this time. So regarding that front, like how to maneuver your public image, your public standing to your advantage, regarding that front, it's a good transit of Mercury in your seventh house. So yes, guys, this is something which I wanted to say as a part of my inputs. For furthermore updates and notifications on the divine science of Vedic astrology, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and follow me on my Instagram account. Dhanyavaad.